24 against the former world champion Denny Moyer, a convincing victory. He was really on his way. But there were tough opponents to be met even after the victory over Denny Moyer. There was, for instance, Cyclone Hart, the TKO artist. And does Anna Firmo have a weakness? Yes, in the fourth round. As you look at it there, you'll see the weakness. A tendency to cut, look, around the eyes. But what are his trademarks really? Stamina, guts. And in the fifth round, he came back to do away with Cyclone Hart. After that, there was to come perhaps the biggest victory of his career against the tough man, Benny Briscoe. And it was this victory over Briscoe in early 78 that led to his title shot against Caro today. This is the way he prepares himself, running, 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 as inevitably fighters do in the early morning. Could be a beach in Maine, but no, the Brooklyn Kid runs right here at Coney Island. Look at the familiar landmarks. After that, another familiar landmark, the gym of Bobby Gleason, a block away from the Garden. And the sparring, the buildup of the very stamina that now is the earmark of Vito Anafirmo. And of course, there is the speed of hands on the bag, getting himself ready for what will be his biggest shot in the history of his boxing life. Boxing so far has been good to Vito Anafirmo. This proves it. A home in one of the better residential areas of Brooklyn. His wife expecting its second child shortly. His little daughter, Lauren. So is there is happiness there where most you would want it. And still there is the dream. The dream that impels him on to become the middleweight champion of the world. And so he's back at it every morning until today.
So a look at Vito Anafirmo up close and personal. Earlier, I had a chance to talk briefly with Vito about his chances in tonight's fight. You're absolutely convinced you can beat him.
Surprising Valdez, staying away from him for 9 rounds, and then coming on with a terrific finishing flurry as you watch him there, his back toward you, cleaning up on Valdez to become the middleweight champion of the world. And then the defense against the home folks in Argentina. Southpaw Ronnie Harris of the United States, whom I saw win the gold medal in 1968 in Mexico City in the lightweight division. But Caro, much too much for him. Not a knockout puncher, but a skilled boxer. And then the rematch against Valdez, November of 78. And the pattern was the way it was in the first fight, only this time more easily. Caro dominating from the beginning, in the vein of Monzon.
Standing 8 counts, unless a fighter is helpless, the mandatory 8 count, no saving by the bell. The ring is 18 feet. They are using Italian gloves. And so the action is underway in the first round. Anafirmo in the black trunks, Caro in the gold. Caro going to the midsection with a left. Caro has labored long and hard in the shadow of Carlos Monzon. Never gotten his countrymen's plaudits the way Monzon did. Hopes that this action will bring him some acclaim similar to that which was accorded Carlos when he held the middleweight crown for 7 long years. A right lead by Caro, picked off by Anafirmo's glove. The referee is Ernesto Magana of Mexico. He has a vote in the scoring. The judges, Roland Dakin of Great Britain and Willie Tom, also of Great Britain. Those three doing the official scoring. In a wary first round thus far, we have gone in a minute and 15 seconds. It is hot in Fonvie Stadium. It is in the mid-80s. Prince Rania is here, as you saw, together with his son Albert and two of Albert's buddies from Amherst College. The lower right-hand corner of your screen indicates the first round countdown, where the action has been sparse. But understandably so, it should develop. think Caro, as there was a little bit of a complaint there about a butt, I think Caro expected Anna Firmo to come out like a bull charging him. Anna Firmo said, I've got a different plan. And indeed, he came out cautiously. Vito trying to bull him now on Marlon. He fights like a bull, Anna Firmo does. The boxing skills are relatively minimal. The thing to remember about Anna Firmo, too, is that he cuts easily. At least that's been his history. 25 seconds left in the first round. We are approaching the end of round one.
Hey, see y'all down the road, Jack. If you're gonna move your family, you can save a lot of money by renting a truck. Moving yourself. And you might as well rent a real truck. A Ryder. Ryder isn't famous for renting cars, beep, beep, little trailers. Ryder's famous for trucks. Pro drivers will tell you that.
Okay, king of the road. Just hold the lamp.
Hey, see y'all down the road, Jack.
Ryder, the best truck money can rent.
On the training, and what do you get? A gold medal.
Got to give it all you got to pour it on.
Pour on the Wheaties, and what do you get? Plenty. Nutritious, good-tasting whole wheat with all the natural brand fiber left in each crunchy golden flake. And 8 important vitamins and iron, too. So make yours a nutritious Wheaties breakfast, then pour it on.
Wheaties is the breakfast of champions.
We're back live at ringside in the Principality of Monaco. Round two just underway. Anna Firmo to the left. Now he is behind Caro in the blue trunk. Caro, the reigning middleweight champion. The first round saw relatively little action, practically no punches thrown, a little bit of bullying by Anna Firmo. And we'd like to alert our local stations along the line that at the end of this round, we'll take a station break. Again, Anna Firmo turns to the bullying tactic. Get the opponent against the rope, and they maybe work him over the belly and get up to the face. But it hasn't happened yet. Caro, the far more stylish fighter. You can see his boxing posture. Again, Ernesto Magana of Mexico is the referee. 1 minute into round two. Anna Firmo's eyes, heavily covered with Vaseline. Hopeful of protecting against what have been in the past the inevitable cut. Caro twice defeated Rodrigo Valdez and also beat the southpaw from Ohio, Ronnie Harris. We're a minute and 40 seconds into the round. This is the second round. And there's been very little clean punching so far in this bout. Waiting in the wings is a fighter from Brockton, Massachusetts, named Marvin Hagler, who TKO'd Norberto Cabrero tonight in this very ring in the eighth round. Hagler had an excellent eighth round in stopping Cabrero. He put his punches together methodically and excellently. But for the first seven rounds, there were some who felt that he was not fighting like the Superman middleweight. He's been built up by some of the press to be. Hagler to get a shot at the winner. Less than 30 seconds left, and so far, we have been devoid of excitement. Right there. You've got a quick glimpse of Caro as to what big counter is. We'll return with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports after this from our local station.
This is Alcatraz. No one has ever escaped from this prison. This is Frank Morris. Morris has escaped from many prisons.
I may have found a way out of here.
No one has ever escaped from Alcatraz.
I'm in.
Me too. And no one ever will.
Clint Eastwood is Frank Morris in Escape from Alcatraz, rated PG.
Now showing at theaters near you in Austin and surrounding areas. Check your newspaper.
Sir.
Oh, Newton, where are you going?
Malfunction in Mansville.
Well, you did try to solve the problem first by long distance, didn't you?
No, I didn't.
Newton, if you can solve the problem by long distance, you save them and yourself a lot of time.
What have I got to lose?
Just a whole day in Mansville.
Just a whole day in Mansville.
Long distance. It's the way to get things done today.
KVUE-TV, Channel 24, Austin.
Third round has just begun here in Monaco. Caro to the left, Antifermo to the right. Middleweight championship at stake. We are, of course, coming to you live. Ernesto Magana, the referee. It is an 18-foot ring. It is scored on a 10-point must system. The first two rounds. Under the order break from Magana, the fighters do the first two rounds. Nothing much happened. I scored the first round even. Subjective scoring gave the second round to Caro, who looks clearly the classier boxer. Ito wants to pull his opponent if he can. That's the way he fights. Big roar for the crowd, from the crowd for Vito, who is their favorite here. Caro is a tough cookie to get through. Watch the way he uses his gloves. Protect himself. Pick off the punch. The crowd is not happy with the action they've seen thus far. What I mean by trying to bull your opponent. Nothing classy about it. It's what Vito is trying to do. We have a minute 22, as you can see, in the third round. Save, and Firmo protected well twice so far in this fight against the right lead. Kept that left up there very well. But you're in the third round now, and you haven't seen but maybe two or three clean blows. Vito's corner is saying like a cat. Inside them all, right there. Caro with a left that got in. Already I see redness over Antifermo's right eye. Vito trying to pull Caro as we approach the end of the third round. Again, live at ringside Monaco, you heard the bell for the start of round four. Antifermo with some redness over the right eye, but no blood yet. Freddie Brown working over it. Very few clean punches. The best blows landed in point of fact by Caro. I scored the first round even and gave the next two to Caro. Again, just one reported subjective scoring. Vito again trying to bully opponent, but you can't score points that way. And Vito is admonished by referee Ernesto Magana of Mexico. See, I told you that Caro is not an offensive fighter. He is a defensive fighter, which is why he failed to please the Argentine public. He moves backward. He counterpunches. And you don't impress a lot of people with that fighting style. But he's been efficient at it. Efficient enough to have won both the WBC and the WBA recognition as middleweight champion of the world. Efficient enough to have surprised Rodrigo Valdez the first time around and to have beaten him much more easily the second time around. A minute and a half into the fourth round. Loud roar as the right of Andrew Firmos finally caught Caro high on the left side of the head. You can understand the crowd roaring because there have been so few clean punches in this fight thus far. Caro there with a good left. A minute left in round four. Again, the clinch. There's been a lot of that. I remarked earlier that Caro is handsome and unmarked. He is very proud of that, and he feels he is that. Vito got in a left there because of the manner in which he fights, so defensively. The fourth round is not long for this world. It's a championship fight. It is, of course, a scheduled 15 rounder. We're back live at ringside in Monaco for the start of the fifth round. Antifermo, the black trunks, and Caro, the defending champion, the gold. Nino Benvenuti, remember him? Past middleweight champion, sitting next to me at ringside, proclaiming Antifermo tough. He is, but he's got to land with punches to score. So many ex-champions here tonight. Emil Griffith is here. He had three wars with Benvenuti. The two are now firm friends. Also here, Rocky Mattioli, the kid who had the hard luck loss to Morris Hope in San Remo, about we did back in the late winter. And Victor Galindez, the reigning light heavyweight champion, is here, rooting for Caro. Benvenuti is right about the toughness and grit of Antifermo. Now he's fighting better. He brought that left up and scored with it. Grit is a great thing. It also helps if you land punches. Minute 20 into the fifth round. Good blow to the midsection by Caro. Caro laughing. Bring him up. There is blood coming from the corner of Antifermo's right eye. A good left and a right combination by Caro. We told you about Antifermo and the facility with which he cuts. Antifermo, aware of the cut, punching strongly against Caro right there. You see the blood pouring down Caro's right, Antifermo's right cheek. 45 seconds left, and Antifermo's corner is yelling, move your hand. Caro got in a good right in that exchange. It is in the corner of the eye, just outside that corner, so should not damage Antifermo's vision. Antifermo trying to bully the opponent, coming up with three consecutive lefts, and then a half rapid punch with the right. trying to maul the opponent, a tactic we told you to look for early on. A warning from Magana to Anafirmo. We come to the close of this, the fifth round. Back live, the sixth round just underway. Caro quickly with some movement, more than he's shown us thus far. Anafirmo, the right eye cut, at least temporarily repaired by Freddie Brown, who's been a wizard. Exercised manual leisure to me through all of the years that I've known him in boxing, almost as many years as I've lived. Freddie now, heaven knows, must be late 70s, or no, he's in his 80s. Vito being the aggressive. Again, the clinch, falling, brawling. Not a lot of skill. Anafirmo, in reality both fighters, but more Anafirmo. I think you see Vito's tactics pretty clearly at this point in a pattern. It's pretty tough to wrest a world championship away from an opponent unless you outpunch him, outscore him cleanly. So far, in the first five rounds, that has not been happening. Caro with a good left that reopened mildly that cut. Caro with a right lead. His are the cleaner blows, the more impactful. You see that blood in the corner of Anafirmo's right eye reopened. Caro remains up to this point unmarked. 45 seconds left in the sixth round. We will stay between rounds. Take a closer look. There you see the same attempt to bolt. Arms around Caro in the corner and then trying the punches from right field. 20 seconds left. See Anafirmo missing with every attempted blow there. Missed five times in a row. The end of the round at hand. Anafirmo to his corner. He's clearly in no danger. There is the one cut that was mildly reopened in the corner of the right eye. Caro seems utterly unmarked. Well, they're working over a little mouse under the left eye. See that? Those fingers know how to minister to that situation. They've been doing it for a long time. Caro, a tremendously attractive young man, but a man who wants to get recognition. And his style of fighting, as I've said, is not conducive to it. The bell, and we are said earlier that neither fighter had a real knockout punch despite their number of KOs. Oh! There you saw the bulling by Anafirmo, and let me call your attention to those ropes. They're among the worst I have ever seen. They are very loose, and they are very tough. You could get rope burns brutally. There is no padding around those ropes, none that I could feel in testing them before the fight. They're very loose and very low, and it's conceivable that a fighter could go right through those ropes or over them and onto the ring apron and maybe even into the crowd. I don't understand why these ropes were permitted to be in this condition. McGanna has just penalized, taken a point away from Antifermo for butting. And that is where that bullying tactic can get you into terrible trouble. You saw McGanna turn to each of the judges, take that finger, and point it, indicating a point taken away. We're a minute and a half into round seven. There'll be no attempt to tell you that this is an outstanding fight. It has not been. Antifermo has not been able to land cleanly on Caro at all, and Caro's style of fighting, while effective in terms of point scoring, is not crowd pleased. Look at that. Not a pretty scene. 1 minute left in round seven. Crowd beginning to whistle and boo. They've grown accustomed to this pace in the Principality of Monaco. The Prince was here a week ago. He's here tonight. Last week, they saw the spectacle of Leon Spinks. Seconds to go. Coming now to the end of the round. And Marvin Hagler is sitting here, and he is probably licking his chops in anticipation. We're back live, the start of the eighth round. Caro, Gold Trunk, Antifermo, Black Trunk, at stake, middleweight crown, both WBC and WBA. Same tactic. Would be efficient if he could get through with some punches. Because you maul an opponent that way, you can wear down the opponent's body. Yep. That looked like a block by Caro and an attempt by a defensive lineman to come around him, holding him behind the neck. We're almost a minute into this round, and you tell me where the blows have been. Would also like to alert our local stations along the line that at the end of this round, we'll take a station break. Whistles, cat calls, some boos. Minute 20. Corner is telling Vito to stick, but you notice that Vito, and I told you at the beginning, he is not a good boxer. He is not the kind of man who efficiently can stick and move. In boxing parlance, that simply means jabbing with the left, scoring with it, moving, keeping away from the opponent. Good left against the ropes by Caro. Good clean left. Minute left in the eighth round. Well, sometimes it has the look of a wrestling match. Caro with that right. Note that the real punches are being scored by Caro, no matter how infrequent. Roundhouse left hook by Caro. Quick left uppercut by Caro. We'll return with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports after this from our local station.
UETV, Channel 24, Austin.
Back live in Monaco, perhaps more live than the bout. It is the ninth round. Antifermo, not able to score successfully from the advent of the fight against Caro, a defensive style fighter. War of the wrestling. Saw some wrestling, some blows thrown that did not get through. Caro got in a couple of grazing blows. Trying to dart him on, encourage him. Just to reset for you, this is the ninth round of the middleweight championship bout, both WBA and WBC versions. Caro, the defending champion in the gold, Vito Antifermo from Brooklyn, the challenger in the black trunks. We have gone through, as noted, eight rounds. It has not been an action fight. Styles, one man, Antifermo, fights in a bull-like, non-skillful boxing fashion. Caro, the champion, fights in a defensive manner, moving backwards, counter-punching. What clean blows have been landed, it seems to me, have been landed by Hugo Caro. Again, subjective view. Nothing official. There has been one cut in the fight. It was a cut in the corner of Antifermo's right eye. It was not a bad cut. Freddie Brown in Antifermo's corner fixed it. Then the cut was mildly reopened. That's been fixed. It hasn't been cut again, which shows you how few and far the blows have been. Because Antifermo usually cuts easy. Not a mark on Caro at all. Caro just looks down as Antifermo holds on to him. And we are coming now to the end of another eventful round, round nine.
There's more than one way the cat can cover a lot of ground. Because the cat's full of surprises. Three surprising cars from your Lincoln Mercury dealer with better EPA gas mileage estimates than Toyota Celica. Mercury Bobcat with Lincoln Mercury flare. Mercury Capri, the look of Europe. Mercury Zephyr, an efficient-sized family car with a style all its own. All at surprising year-end prices right now at the Sign of the Cat.
Inside Firestone's newest 721 radial are two belts of steel cord. In each cord, 10...
Round 10 just underway. Perhaps you heard the bell. Caro, Hugo Caro in the gold trunks, Antifermo in the black. We are still waiting for some outbreak of clean punishment punching action. We have not seen it in this bout. That has been Vito Antifermo throughout the fight. Surging forward, rushing, clutching the opponent, pulling him, but not scoring. Occasionally, Caro has scored, and cleanly. But he has been no whiz-bang at all with his defensive style of fighting. Backing off. Moves well on his feet going backwards, but... Look at them. And we're a minute into round 10. Don't forget, tomorrow on ABC's Wide World of Sports, you'll see action from the Larry Holmes-Mike Weaver fight of a week ago Friday night at the Garden. The fight that was so regaled by some of the boxing press. Minute and a half into the 10th round. Vito did get a left in there. This will not be one of your more memorable fights, you viewers. Caro trying to go to the midsection. Less than a minute left. You must hear Vito's corner trying to encourage him. Seconds left in the 10th round. Coming to the end of the 10th round. It ends the way it began. Seventh round action live from ringside in the Principality of Monaco. Middleweight championship at stake. WBC, WBA version. Quick complaint by Caro about a low blow from Anafirmo. Slip, forget it. No knockdown. Caro, gold trunks. Anafirmo, black trunks. No need to labor the fact that this has been a downright dull fight. Matter of fact, I'm going to try to get Marvin Hagler, the Brockton Jr. blockbuster, to ringside to get his view, because he'll be fighting the winner of this, presumably in September, for the middleweight crown. Hagler tonight earlier fought Norberto Cabrera. Fought methodically, not brilliantly, and then in the eighth round, he purposefully did away with the opponent. He can punch. The hands are rapid. He gets through. He's unafraid. And speaking of Hagler, this is a ragged, shoddy exhibition. One would like to see A, some evidences of boxing skill, and B, some clean punches landed. Right there, Caro got in a left, and look at that. Again, Anafirmo is warned. Come on over, Marvin, sit down right here. Marvin Hagler is with me now at the end of this round. I'm going to have a quick chat with him. Crowd is yelling, Vito, 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 as he finally scored with a couple of punches. But basically, it is the same. Trying to bowl, mauling, brawling, no clean punching, very little scoring, if any, by Anafirmo throughout the bout. Caro fighting his way defensively, moving backwards, counterpunching. We are approaching the end of the round. That's the end of the 11th round as I mark my score. And as I get ready to talk with Marvin Hagler, who, as I told you, TKO'd Norberto Cabrero earlier this evening in the eighth round. Marvin, now you're getting a chance to watch the world middleweight champion in action against Andrew Firmo, the number two ranked WBA contender, number five WBC. Honestly, what's your view? 12th round action. Sitting two rows behind me is Michael Katz of the New York Times, their boxing writer. He went up to New England and saw Marvin Hagler fight for the first time a number of months back and immediately proclaimed Hagler the best middleweight in the world. The crowd is yelling, but it's much ado about nothing. It's what you've been saying all fight long. Oh, that time, Andrew Firmo finally got in a couple of lefts. Look at that. Holding Garo with his left and trying to punch him with his right. Just letting you watch this. Marvin Hagler next to me making disparaging remarks about what's going on in the ring, and I don't blame him. There it is again. We have 45 seconds left in this round. Maybe you could score this round for Anna Firmo on grounds of sheer bull-like tenacity. Certainly not in terms of skill, but Caro is merely defense. With the left, punch with the right. That's the Anna Firmo tactic in this round. So the end of the round mercifully comes as Anna Firmo like tactics to come on strongly in the late going. And he does have tremendous stamina. That may be his greatest asset of all. Quickly, they go into the wrestling posture again. Caro, surprisingly little foot movement. I'm really surprised at that. Caro was hit by a left there and started immediately to cover up. He does not like to have his face marked. That's all right if you're a youthful Ali and have the skills that an Ali has. Round action. More wrestling. Caro, who has a bigger looking body than Andrew Firmo, may be showing some signs of fatigue. Trying to get some movement in there to avoid some of those bull-like rushes, but not successful. Come on, different demeanor to Caro this round than in the last half of last round, too. He doesn't like to take any kind of punishment. And those bull-like rushes of Anna Firmo may have taken something out of him, which undoubtedly was Vito's plan. Certainly, Caro has not been counterpunching or throwing any leather in the last two rounds. And we're almost at the end of this round. This fight could tighten up, regardless of its absence of skills. We're counting down to the end of round 13. And Caro is not fighting.
In April, a killer tornado roared through Wichita Falls, Texas, smashing 2,000 houses to kindling. One of them stood here.
The sky got black, and we all ran into the closet. When we came out, the house was gone. We contacted Allstate, and within a couple of days, we had the money.
We're set up to get here fast, get the customer taken care of. That's what we're here for.
Help when you need it. That's a promise from the Good Hands people.
They were the first insurance people I saw on the block.
Oil and gas aren't the only forms of energy our country's got to develop more of these days. There are four others. First, there's coal. Second, there's nuclear energy. Third, there's solar energy. And fourth, there's you and all the rest of us. The more energy we save, the less we'll have to depend on imports. So let's put conservation to work, along with coal, nuclear, and solar power, to provide energy for you. Energy for all of us.
We're back live, and the crowd now is yelling for Anna Firmo because so many of them are knowledgeable boxing fans. They detected what I've already brought to your attention, that the last two rounds, Caro did no fighting. Anna Firmo's stamina, his greatest asset. And this fight has tightened up in terms of the scoring. Not in terms of the attractiveness of the performance for you viewers, perhaps, though they've each done their best. But Caro has stopped fighting. He has stopped punching. And indeed, as I look at my scorecard, it may be that Anna Firmo won the 11th round, too. Right there, trying to fight back, is Hugo Caro. I still say Hugo Caro with a good right there. It's tough for a fighter to win a title away from a champion on the basis of what Anna Firmo has shown. But that's a matter for the judges.